everyone, welcome back to Bird Brain Gaming. Today I've got $240 worth of quarters to search through. I'm gonna be looking for my usual low mint 2009s, 10s, 11s, I think some 14s, somewhere around that range. I'll let you know if I find low mints. I'm gonna look for any W quarters from West Point, the 2019s or 2020s. I'm gonna look for any San Francisco mints, any silver minted, pre or post 64, or any obvious errors. I've got 16 rolls that are bank wrapped, and I've got 8 rolls that are customer wrapped. I'm gonna start off with the customer wrapped rolls first. So let's check out what's in these rolls.
There's nothing but the smell of a perfume. And don't you feel like you're crying? Don't you feel like crying? Don't you feel like crying? Come on, cry to me. Whoa, nothing can be sadder than a glass of wine alone. Loneliness, loneliness is such a waste of time. was love in summer night. Then, remember,
garden. so am I. Maybe millions of people go by, but they all disappear.
I'm done sorting through all the quarters. This is what I found. I did not find any pre-64s, silvers, or San Francisco mints. I did find $3 worth of bicentennials. I like to collect the bicentennials and make separate quarter rolls from them. For the coins that are new, I have these 2023 quarters here that I did not know of. I have the Maria Tall Chief and the Eleanor Roosevelt quarters. They're both Philly mints, Philadelphia mints. I also found three quarters, nothing too special about them other than their condition. I'm gonna keep them because of how great their condition is. This Utah 2007, this Apostle Islands 2018, and this Weir Farm 2020. I'm keeping these because they're in really great shape. They are all Denver mint. That's why they're in really good condition, but they barely have any marks, like very light marks on them and good reflection. So that's why I'm keeping them. Also, I found one little error quarter. This is the Homestead 2015. It has a leaky bucket. Under the bucket, it's very, it has what you call, like a crack. If you see under the bucket, there's supposed to be a spacing under it, but there is none. It's a big crack right under it. So I'm gonna keep that just because of that little crack. Other errors to note are on the roof of the house. So if you see like large cracks on top of the roof, hang on to those too. So for the low mints, these are the low mint quarters that I found. Starting with the 2009s. I have three District of Columbias. They are 83.6 million copies of these quarters, which is pretty low. Anything under 100 million is considered a bit low. I also have three from Puerto Rico, 2009. The Puerto Ricos have different amounts. The Philadelphia mints are 53.2 million and the Denver minted are 86 million. Let's see what I got. Philly, Denver, and Philly. So two Phillies, one Denver for Puerto Rico. The Philly is the only lowest mint, like I said, 53.2 million. So if you ever find those, hang on to them. Also, I have one from the US Virgin Islands, 2009. The mint mark is Denver. There are approximately 41 million copies of that one. So that's low as well. And also found one quarter from the Samoan Islands, 2009. This one, I believe, is the lowest mint of the year. Actually, no, second lowest. The Northern Mariana Islands are the lowest, and I did not find any of those. The Samoa, this mint is a Philly mint, Philadelphia mint. There are 42.6 million copies of this quarter. Moving on to the 2010s, I found two. I have one from the Grand Canyon and one from Yosemite Park in California. The mint marks are Philly and Philly. Let's see how many of them there are. So for the Grand Canyon, 34.8 million. That is extremely low. And Yosemite, 35.2 million copies of these quarters. So both of these are considered really low. If you ever see them, hang on to them. Just because of rarity. I also found four quarters from 2011. I have one from Chickasaw. This is in Oklahoma. Isn't it Oklahoma? Looks like Oklahoma. Yep. This is what mint? Philadelphia Mint, 2011. There are approximately 73.8 million copies of that quarter. That's moderately low. Also, Gettysburg from 2011. This is a Philly Mint, Philadelphia Mint. There are 30.8 million. That is extremely low. 30.8 million, Gettysburg, Pennsylvania. That is low. If you see those, hang on to them. Also got, looks like a glacier. This is in Montana, 2011. Mint mark. Philadelphia. So the glacier from Philly, 30.4 million. Extremely low. Hang on to those if you see them. And the last one from 2011, Olympic. That is in Washington, Washington State. There are, let's see, what mint is this? Philadelphia Mint for Olympic. 30.4 as well, 30.4 million copies of that quarter, extremely low. So the 2011 quarters, hang on to, there are a low quantity of them that are distributed throughout the country. For rarity purposes, I suggest you hang on to them. Next one, 2012 Hawaii volcanoes. If you've seen a previous quarter video, I pulled a business strike San Francisco of this one. Today, the one I found is a Philadelphia Mint. 2012 Hawaii, let's see how many there are. We have 46.2 million copies. I'll even show you right here. Hawaii. 2012 P, 46.2 million. the book that I'm looking through, United States Coins 2023 edition. And the last quarter for today, Great Smoky Mountains 2014. This is Tennessee. What mint is this? Philadelphia 2014 Great Smoky Mountains. Let's see how many there are. There are 73.2 million. So from that year, that's one of the lowest minted quarters from 2014. The rest you don't need to keep. I would just recommend the Great Smoky Mountains of 2014 to keep. Alright guys, if you enjoyed this content, smash that like button, hit the subscribe button, leave a comment if you like, and I'll see you all next time on Bird Brain Gaming. Later everyone. Happy.